Rabbi Melech Leib Dubrow is a nutritionist and pastoral counselor. After discovering Chabad as a college student, he wrote to the Rebbe about marrying someone who was not observant and had an audience in 1971.
I became religious and then came to Hadarah Torah. So I wrote in this 15-page letter, described the relationship, and asked the Rebbe how to proceed, what to do. Now, I told this young lady that I was going in to see the Rebbe and that I'd be asking that question, and she wrote a letter as well. Not 15 pages, only a page and a half. But I included it in my letter. So at that point, now, when you come into the Rebbe, you're opposite the desk from him, and next to the desk, if I remember correctly, it was on the right-hand side. It was a long credenza return, and he had the letters stacked up vertically there. So still looking straight at me, he reaches back from this stack of must have been hundreds of letters and pulls out her letter. He says, "This was written to you. This belongs to you." And he hands the letter back to me. And then he gave me an answer to the letters. And basically his answer was composed of three parts. The first one he said is, "A wife is not a student." Now, I had become religious in this time, but this young lady had been raised Reform, West Coast Reform, if we can use such labels. And she had no knowledge, really, of Yiddishkeit practices. And he said, a wife is not a student. In all the matters in which she should be expert, natural for her to be expert, you would have to teach her. And that's not a correct relationship between a husband and wife. It's not, of course, that they can't learn, but in those matters in which she should be expert, she would have the knowledge, I would be teaching her. And the Rebbe said, that's not a correct relationship. A wife is not a student. The next thing he said was, really, all in a sense, I take it as how one finds one's beshared. He said like this, before marriage, there has to be a bond. The woman has to have a desire and understanding of what the man wants most in his life. And the man has to have a desire and understanding in what she wants most in her life. In other words, each one has to know the other's vision for their life and support it 100%. Understand it and want it for the other person 100%. They don't have to have the same vision for their lives, but they have to want and desire that the other person should achieve their vision. And when a couple has that, the Rebbe said, then there's a bond, there's a foundation for a marriage, a lasting marriage. So that was the second part of his answer. The third part, this young lady wrote in the letter that she was two things that I remember clearly. First of all, she was sure that the Rebbe was going to break us apart. But she could never keep kosher in her home. These are the things she wrote. And the Rebbe said, please, a personal request from me, the Rebbe said, tell this young lady, actually he said this young miss, that I have no intention of separating you from her, chas v'shalom, or her from you. However, continuing the relationship, you're doing her harm. This is what he said to me. You're doing this young miss harm. You're confusing her, you're not enabling her to see her situation, and you're preventing her from finding a suitable match. Now, I didn't exactly understand what the Rebbe was saying, what this all referred to. I found out years later, but this is what the Rebbe said. Now, before giving you the third answer to the three questions I asked, I should tell you that years later, we did break it off. Years later, I saw this, returning to Los Angeles, I saw this young lady in the store. She had one kid on one hip and another one on the other one. And turns out that within 2 months of our breaking it off, she got married to a fine fellow. But she told me, somewhat astoundingly, she said, do you know that one of the requirements I made of my husband before I would marry him? I said, no, how would I know? She said, I demanded that our house be kosher. Now, in the letter she'd written, she could never keep kosher. But one of the requirements that she made of her husband, and this is what the Rebbe said, that She was not seeing, able to see, because of the emotional involvement, she wasn't able to see what her true desire was. And as soon as that emotional involvement had been separated, broken, she was able to see what her true desire was. So those three things, again, that a wife is not a student. The relationship between a husband and wife has to be, there has to be equality there. Each has their areas of expertise. Second, that there has to be a bond, and the bond has to be based on this vision that the other person has and the support of each one to the other. And third, that oftentimes emotional involvement can cloud what each one wants and what their true desire is.